this is pretty interesting to watch. Senator Durbin clearly came ready to play. A lot of the questions that Democrats have had are about whether the immigration proposals, policies of the administration are motivated by racism. And that was also part of what he was trying to get at as he was talking to the secretary.
And I actually think that the secretary has proved the point here that many of us have been saying over the last couple of days.
You can't do it in a 2.5.
The White House was never going to be the final deal,
no,
right?
It
was
just. I'm with David, and I've written about this, that the specific word doesn't matter. Tom Cotton and David Perdue in various. I just think the Perdue Cotton position is increasingly untenable, especially because you see here the White House essentially again admitting that he did this. I don't know where you kind of go. Maybe it disappears, but in terms of, not that there's that much comedy in the Senate, C-O-M-I-T-Y, not comedy, but even so, I mean, you have Tom Cotton and David Perdue essentially calling Dick Durbin a liar.
It does, and it does sort of, in a way, help you decide where certain people are in backing up President
right.
Trump on this. I'm going to have you guys stick around because we have a really important thing to talk about, because just minutes just before this hearing, our Jake Tapper sat down with Senator Dick Durbin to talk about that Oval Office meeting. Here is his exclusive interview. And welcome back. We just heard Jake Tapper's exclusive interview with Democratic Senator Dick Durbin. They discussed that infamous Oval Office meeting where President Trump referred to African countries in vulgar terms and said he wanted more immigrants from Norway. Senator Durbin also applauded his Republican Senator Lindsey Graham for speaking out at that meeting. And joining me now.
Again, I think all of that belies the point that Graham was trying to make to the president.
It doesn't matter whether he said S house or S hole, as Senator Durbin said. Is that their defense when he was asking
exactly.
about Republican senators who might have been splitting hairs on that? One of the things I found interesting about this interview and also about Secretary Nielsen's take on the words that were used that we heard Senator Durbin pretty credibly describe with backup from Senator Graham, she seems to really emphasize what the president was saying about Norway to the president, that they are hardworking, that they have low crime. She is purposely de-emphasizing the whole point of this, which Jake really got to in that interview, which is the idea of African countries being discussed in derogatory terms and European countries being discussed as something to aspire to, what
right.
should be coming into the
so
U.S.
She's serving as the presidential translator in some way, right? And the most interesting was actually something that I was reminded of, a Republican aide shortly after the remarks came out and anything else, and it just came out appearing to be very racist or something that Democrats seized on and called very racist. I think what that...
I defer to Phil and I'm with Phil on that. It was semi-painful slash awkward to watch the department remember
convenient
that.
Convenient memory
I just feel like
be.
You'd remember it. I actually think...
She said that rough language was being used all around, and Senator Durbin said, basically, did you hear me curse?
Right,
and
or
she said,
Senator
no.
Graham.
I mean, she was able to definitively say that Durbin did not,
yeah.
and that Graham, that he was recounting what the president had said. I mean, her recollections actually sounded pretty specific.
Well, I just
sure
decades ago. This
you
was
were somewhere
the
else.
Always contentious Washington Post.
You're in more intense
meetings. No, that's just human nature to me.
Sure,
it just seems unlikely.
And she's
that
been
be
challenged in that regard. I think one of the bigger issues here, David, might be that there's clearly a pressure that has been made so clear from this president, whether it's Secretary Nielsen or senators who want to ally themselves with him, whether it's the Attorney General, that they have to kowtow to what he wants to hear.
Well, this goes exactly to what you were just saying about how she proved her record.
Leave it there, gentlemen. Thank you so much. David Challey and Phil Mattingly and Chris Saliza, appreciate it. And tune into Wolf at 1 o'clock for the second part of Jake Tapper's exclusive interview with Democratic Senator Dick Durbin. Inside Politics with John King begins after a quick break.